Hi, welcome to my channel Caterpillar Jun Hank. Well, I'm here with it again just to share you something that very interesting. Okay, it is regarding about the piece Komatsu 470. Okay, so this Komatsu 470, it is an electric. I'm going to switch it on now, so you can see there's no power light. Even the position of switch is going to start, but not going on. Now, I will show you something again. I will show you why that is happen. I'm going down to the machine, and then we will show you why that why the switch is not functioning. Here's the fuse. I'll try to see the fuse. Just wait a second. Okay. So in this situation, there is a fuse here. Actually, this is the fuse that have a permanent supply. Okay. We'll check the three fuse. It is good. Okay. And then the other one. This is damaged. That damage, they already put a jumper. You see, it's already have jumper. And also this fuse is already have a jumper, so you can see. So the fuse is still broken or what? Okay, a temporary make a jumper. Make a hard type of fuse. It is jumpered already. So just to see if there is a reaction about the if the battery switch will be switching on. This is good. Okay. We will see it again. But still no power. Okay. This fuse is already have a jumper. The jumper is good. Also, this fuse is good. This four fuse, it is came from the battery. Okay. This four fuse came from battery, and then this one is for the shut off motor. Okay. And then the both two is for ignition and hazard. Okay, so this four fuse have a permanent supply from battery. Okay, just because this Arabic, so you can see it is Arabic, we do not know how to read. Okay, we will see the lower side, ground side. Oh, ground side, sorry. I'm going down, but still no power. Even the hazard. Oh, the hazard power is available. Okay. But the ignition is not available. Now I'm going down. Okay. We'll see you there. You know, the purpose of this video, why I make it, just to keep somebody's give an information regarding about if they encounter the same problem. Okay, actually I already make a jumper because the IC is already broken because of a corrosion of copper. See, so you can see that. So I already cut there also and then make it a connection. this wire, the socket number LR3, it is connected to the accelerator motor. Okay, this is a supply of the shut-off motor, sorry, this is a supply. So I already make it because I was repair only the shut-off motor. So I'm going at the back of this machine, come to the back just to see what happened. Actually, the model of this machine is 470, WA470, Showell Komatsu. This is a Komatsu. This is Komatsu. Okay. Actually, if this happen, the problem is, well, there is a rectifier. As you can see, we are here in the rear side of the engine, and then the fan. If you can see, there is the engine mounting. Okay, under the engine mounting, there is a harness. This harness, okay, this is the harness. Okay, this harness, there is an included diode just to switching on the battery relay. This is the battery relay. Okay, so you can see from now on, before I already tested, they put directly. I don't know who the put direct this wire. Okay, maybe one of our electrician in the side. So they put this wire directly from the ignition switch. Okay, so what I do, I already remove, I didn't connect it, so I connect the original wire. So you can see there, under this battery switch, this is the original wire. It was disconnected before. Okay, it was disconnected before. So this is the wire was connected when this machine is came. Okay, okay, this is the wire is connected here. So you can see, it's getting on enough. So I will not use this direct wire. I'm going to return to the original wire. Why? There is a rectifier here. So you can see we are in an exhaust side. I call it, mostly the diode is in here, this area, but because there is someone already removed, as you can see, they already extended or removed from the harness. Okay, so you can see this is the wire of diode. So this wire is only used for the alternator in here, this connection. Okay, for the indicator. So I'm going to take it out, the original wire. Okay, so this is the wire came from that was used diode. Okay, the problem here is there's no supply going out to the battery switch to energize the battery switch. Okay, this is the battery switch. Okay, okay, actually they joined this wire. This wire must be separate. As we can see, this must be connected to the two diode. Okay, what hard to remove the pig. Actually, this is the type of diode. But the original diode that we have here is not same like this. This is designed for a Caterpillar, okay, or a Perkins engine. So I'm going to use this diode as for a temporary, but we need one more. First, I have to remove the wire or the joint in this area. My God, this is very what we call, see, this is the wrong connection. Okay, this wire must be separate. Okay, and then one of the wire siya wala wala ha? Siya wala wala ha?
Sure
Maherit. Okay, now this is the situation. How this rectifier work? Okay, this is the situation. Okay, actually, this line is producing positive. It is producing positive. Okay, so they split into two diode. They split this wire, three wire, into two diode. Okay, as you can see, the positive side of the diode is in here, going to the battery switch, and the other side, it is also what we call this, also the positive. This is a positive, and then must be the negative side of the diode will be connected here, this side. Okay, and then the positive side will be here for the line of alternator. This alternator, as we can see, this terminal. Okay, this is the alternator was setting up the light inside the cabin. Okay, so the connection now, as we can see, okay, we'll put, now for now on, the supply is not available here, but when I put the supply here, the battery switch is now sitting on. See, battery switch is sitting on, even here. But when you put directly the supply here, so the battery switch will not shutting off. Okay, must be in here, just to use the diode connection. The rectifier connection, use the rectifier. Use the rectifier to keep the so return supply will not return it or blocked by the dash. They blocked by the rectifier. Okay, so this is now the correct connection. This is the correct connection. Okay, this positive
And then the other diode, lastly the negative side of the diode will be connected here. Connected here. And then the positive side will be in here. This is the indicator line going to cabin, going to what we call starting of the starter, just to keep the starter safety. It will not started after the engine is running. Okay. And also, once this diode connection here is broken or damaged, so it's possible that the indicator or a battery indicator at the top of the machine or the cabin or the monitoring dashboard, the battery sign there is not shutting off. It's always showing light. Okay, we will show you once the diode here is completely, I make it complete. Okay, for now on, I'm going to find the extra diode. As you can see the line here, it is the same color, white and green, and also there is white and green. This line and that line, it is only one connection. Okay, they only just put a diode here to give the supply that came from here once you switch off the engine. Actually, if you put this connection without the rectifier here, so the supply from here, once this dynamo is running without the rectifier here, the shut off motor will not shutting off. Okay, because they permanently giving supply from here. Even you cut off the line inside the cabin, or the key ignition switch, the supply is continuously supplying, giving power for the shut off motor. Okay, this line, it will maintain or continuously giving supply. So that's the purpose why the rectifier they put up here. Okay, to keep the return power will hold or blocked by the diode. Okay, if you imagine that this is the dynamo. Okay, this is the battery side or charging line going to the battery. Okay, and then this is the indicator. They put the bulb just to energize the alternator. Okay, but the original line is this. This is the original line. Okay, so once this diode is energized, this line, or before we start, this line is producing negative low current negative. Once this dynamo, it is started or energized, this line will be automatic positive. So that's the main reason why the shut-off motor will not shutting off. Once the ignition switch is already switched off, so the shut-off motor is still switched on the engine. They will not shutting off because of the line from here, because of this. Okay, we will show you after this once the diode is already completed. So we will show you the result. Okay, how that is work without the rectifier or and with rectifier. This is this is the diode I make. As we can see, this is the steel type of diode. Okay, I put wire. So what I make, this is the negative, okay, negative black color, and then this is the positive. Okay, so now this is the connection I have to do. The negative must be connected, as I told before, the negative must be connected here. Okay, I will join it temporary, or it's either use permanently. And then I'm going to cut this pin or asset.
So now this is the final connection. So you can see both negative, it is joined on the positive line. Okay, join on the positive line, and then they are pass join on an this is a positive supply. Okay, this is a positive supply, this wire yellow black stripe yellow, and then the both negative line of the diode will be connected in one line, and then the both positive side of the diode it will be separate. Okay, the other side of the positive is connected to the alternator wire or the indicator bulb on the cabin, and then the other side is for the battery switch. This is the battery switch. What I'm going now, okay, we will show you after this. Okay, now the wiring connection is done. I extend little because the wire is a bit of short, as you can see yellow and black, or black stripe with yellow. And switch off, Navid, check switch off. Okay, and also before, this is the shut-off motor. I also remove from the socket because there is broken.
Switch on.
1 minute. Okay, I'm here in the rectifier. Okay, on. Okay, as you can see, and then this is the Navido, try start. So I already connect. Wait. Check ada tarap mala. Ada light mal dynamo. Battery light. Switch on all. Battery light, Fee.
Copy.
Okay, check start. Now it's my mistake. Okay, so it should have the diode will be separate by negative and positive. So this is the negative, the black color, and then this is the positive of the other side diode. Okay, as you can see, these are two diode. Okay, so must be from positive will be connected to the negative for the charging indicator, and then the other one must be giving supply to the battery switch. Here is battery switch. Okay, so it will series and parallel the connection of the diode. Okay, so this diode is the purpose is just to kill the return supply, and then the other one purpose is to relay to transfer the supply to the what we call the battery relay. Okay, from negative to positive. Okay, we'll give supply there. Okay, so now it's almost done. The battery indicator is okay. I return it to normal wiring. Okay, but the original diode is not available, so I use other type of diode. It's just not heavy load or not too much load for using of this diode. Okay, so this is it. Again, this is a 470.
at anyone want to question or want to ask about the design of the harness. So I have here the paper. So I will show you about the rectifier. This is the wiring connection, okay? That's the wiring connection of the rectifier, okay? Black and yellow, black, and the other one, white, stripe green, okay, and black. And then where the other line, the black line is going to the battery relay. What I told, battery relay, the black color wire. So that's the connection, okay? So going to the ignition, the black yellow, it is going to the ignition. So you can see the other side is 26. Okay, it is 26. But when you rotate the diagram, it came 25. So you can see 25 black yellow going the socket LR4. LR4 is in here. LR4 is the LR4. Okay, so the wire of ignition switch, it is a black and stripe yellow. Okay, in some electrician that not familiar about this type of troubleshooting, and also he don't understand how to read the diagram, just send us a comment. If you need a diagram, so I will send you the diagram if you want. So there is the LR4. Okay. Yeah, here's the LR4. LR4 going to the ignition switch. So you can see. Here's the LR4, okay? The black and yellow stripe is there until the ignition switch. This is the ignition switch, okay? Black and yellow, that's direct to the ignition switch, okay? So this is it. That's the diagram, electrical diagram of this model of a Shewell 470. Okay, I told before it's almost done. Start. I will remove this diode. We will see if the power will be coming.
Switch off.
Switch off?
Yes.
Okay, switch on. Because this diode is giving supply to the battery relay, so it cannot start once the battery relay is not energized. Wow, sabar. Okay, so that's the connection why we need a rectifier or diode. Okay, that's the importance of the rectifier in this machine, because this machine is no controlled by electronic. It is almost manual. But about the starting situation, switching on battery, they are using rectifier or diode. Okay, so this is it. Thank you for watching, Caterpillar Jun Hank, at your service. Send us all of your comments, okay, regarding about, or if you need something, say hi. Show your face. Yeah. He is my companion. to do this job, because if I'm I do alone, it's very hard to go up and down. Go up and down, it's not easy. Okay, so again, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. So don't forget to hit the notification bell, all, select all, for if you are interested all of my contents or a video, so you will be updated. Okay, at any time I'm the doing upload the videos I have. Okay, bye bye. This is now totally closed, because this must be permanent.